It's a backlog of ships and tons of consumer cargo that they carry, and the port of Savannah right in the middle of all of it.
It's the third largest port in the country and now busier than anyone might have ever believed.
What you see here is happening in the middle of the night every day of the week, every single day. And I think that's one thing that people don't understand. They have this image that we pack up and go home at 5 o'clock. That is not the case. The ILA and the GPA are out here around the clock.
Griff Lynch says the supply chain is complicated and they are unloading cargo as fast as possible.
How many ships are out there in the queue today?
So we have about 7 container vessels that were working at our ports today, and we have approximately 25 out at anchor today.
Lynch says longshoremen are working overtime, but that thousands of containers are piling up. The port has been planning for several years to provide more space.
We're implementing the plan. There are some bumps in the road. The bumps have not been only caused by the port. I want to make sure we make that clear. The entire supply chain is challenged. We're just one piece of the supply chain. So if there's not enough warehousing and the cargo backs up, it's going to impact the ports and it's going to impact the number of vessels we have at anchor. We are establishing potentially what we're calling the supply chain relief program, where we're taking freight and sending it to underutilized rail facilities. Whereas most ports are full, there are rail facilities and inland locations that are not full. So how can we use them better?
Lynch says, bottom line, there's a constant effort to keep the cargo moving, but he does acknowledge this won't be solved overnight and may last for several months.
There's been a great effort. Cargo is moving.
Lynch saying all of this is unprecedented, but he does say he believes that most of those consumer goods will be on the shelves by the holiday season. Reporting from the Port of Savannah, I'm Joanne Merrigan, WSAV News 3, on your side.